Aniba is the fastest growing store for digital game keys. With a huge selection of titles at the best price, Aniba quickly became the go-to place to find all the best gaming deals, boasting over 2 million monthly users. If this sounds like it's for you, use our link in the description. Hi, this is Rob from Studio 35, here to share this week's gaming news with you. You know what's going to be first. Hell, if you're on Mars, you'd still know the big gaming story of the week. After much hype and delay, Naughty Dog has finally released The Last of Us Part 2. Many outlets scored the game over 90% out of 100, a score many expected, while those who dared to score lower received the usual flack or accusations of bias. Controversy arose in the lead-up to the game's release when several large-scale review outlets voiced their concern at how strict the embargo rules were, which stripped them of the ability to wholeheartedly communicate how they felt about the game, who felt that the game's violence sometimes overshadowed the emotional high points. Keep an eye out for Studio 35's upcoming coverage of The Last of Us 2 for our take on this highly anticipated game. A few days ago, Amazon France whipped the gaming world up into a frenzy when it supposedly leaked the upcoming PlayStation 5's price, reportedly at around 500 euros. However, TechRadar is reporting that this leak was in fact fake, and that a spokesperson from Amazon France has informed them that this image isn't actually from their website at all. This comes at the exact same time that rumors are ramping up that the upcoming digital-only lower-spec next-gen Xbox, currently codenamed Lockhart but expected to ship with the S moniker, will be coming in at a wallet-friendly price of around $200, thanks to a leaker on the Beyond3D forum who has a reputation for accurate leaks in the past. Big news in the world of Stadia this week, with the gaming platform receiving major updates to its offering. After last month's major 5-game giveaway, Stadia is now cutting the price of its hardware kit, dubbed the Premier Edition, to $100. Previously priced at $129, this new price will not include the 3 months of Stadia Pro as before, as everyone is now eligible for a month of Stadia Pro when trying out the service. In other Stadia news, thanks to a setting in its app, Stadia is now officially, stroke unofficially, supporting all Android phones. It might not work 100% on all phones, but toggling on the Play on this device option in experiments should enable you to play on your particular Android device. Finally, in Stadia news, Google has added a virtual gamepad to its service so that you can play any game on any device without having to use a controller at all. Pretty nifty considering the Stadia controller still can't be used wirelessly with mobile devices. Pokémon Snap is making its way to the Nintendo Switch, and it's a not a N64 remake. Bandai Namco is bringing a whole new title to the series that allows you to capture photos of pocket monsters. There is currently no planned release date, but a trailer has been dropped on the official Pokémon Twitter account. Speaking of the Nintendo Switch, EA has announced that 7 of its titles will be making their way to the Nintendo handheld, including multiplayer games like Apex Legends. By the time you read this, Burnout Paradise will be available to buy also. The announcement was made during EA's Play livestream by Adam Freeman, community manager at EA, who said, "It's all about giving you the freedom to play where you want, when you want, and with who you want. It's about playing together." And those are the major events this week in the world of gaming. What were your highlights? You tell us in the comments below. But before we go, I'd like to share some internal news. Studio 35 will now be adding membership tiers to our gaming channel, and would like to hear what perks you would like as part of its membership tiers. And as usual, if you like what you see, don't forget to like this video as it makes our content more visible. Subscribe to catch our future content and share this video across all your favorite social media platforms to support our growth. This is Robbie Yap from Studio 35, wishing you all a happy weekend.